So welcome, people of God. So I want to share something with you. And so first of all, let me just give you the most sincerest, warmest, biggest thanks. God bless you. I can to those of you that commented under the last word that I released, which was not a prophetic word. It was my testimony. Thank you for the emails. Thank you for the comments. Thank you. Thank you. A million thank yous. I needed, not me. Okay. Thank you, Holy Spirit, for that immediate correction. God needed for you to hear me speak about my personal investments in governing this house and how difficult it was, because a house that I was in the loss of my spiritual mother, like how difficult in the middle of my you know, process, losing her, like the suddenness of it, not understanding. I needed you to know how personal my yes is, not just to God, but to every single person that says to me, I need to be here. Like, because there are people that come through that, you know, but for the person that has said to me, because that was what my relationship was with my spiritual mother. Like, we were connected, right? So there are those of you that, to me personally, you've said, I need to be here. Like, in the deepest, darkest time, that was what she meant to me. So for me to now be having a ministry that I am governing, God needed you to hear how scary that was for me because of my own loss. So thank you again for all of you that, like, listen, you sow here, you love on me, you pray for me. Thank you a million times over. And so along the lines of talking about, you know, that sort of thing, the significance of that ministry was teaching me, correcting me on the posture of my prayers and petition, right? That was where so much of my growth and my correction took place, because I really thought that I was praying the right way. I really did. I really didn't understand why I loved God so much and I was so desperate for performance and nothing was happening. I was so desperate for performance and nothing was happening. And so along those lines, a moment I was just having with God during my God time, and I was just kind of like writing it down and I was journaling it, is because during that time, right, it's something that God, and that thing, let me just say this right, that teaching, that correction is what I try to do here. That is what personally I am going to, thank you, Jesus, coach and develop and grow. And those of you that are like, my life has to change. I can't play church anymore. My life has to change. And so the biggest thing was how I was petitioning God, how I was praying, right? And so let me tell you, around the same time when I really started to like grow spiritually, it naturally, I was growing, and I'm talking about like in corporate America, and I'm getting somewhere. And so I don't think I've ever really like made sense of this before or said this. So I left Atlanta and went to Greenville, South Carolina. Maybe I have said this before. And I had gotten a job at Verizon. That's where I started. And so listen, and you've heard, and it's still who I am. I talk in a lot of slang. Like sometimes I will say stuff and I know that it's slang, right? And when I got to Verizon, I would say words that when I would get coached by my leader, you know, even if the customer didn't make mention of it, my leader would say, what was that thing that you just said? Like I used to say, I don't know. Like, I don't know if you're from the South or whatever, but instead of saying, I don't know, right? First of all, which you shouldn't be saying to a customer that needs your help, I would say, I don't know. So a customer would say, what do you think happened to my phone? I don't know. Like, I'm being transparent here. And it drove my senior manager, not even my supervisor, it drove him crazy. And he would say, we can't tolerate that. And so I used to have, and this is so, it was so embarrassing. I used to take dictation classes, like pronunciation, because my slang was so, I was so Atlanta. Like that's what people used to say. I was so, and so anyway, because I'm really getting somewhere. Me and God just had a moment during my God time. And I was praying about something. And I was praying about my business, right? And I was like, oh, Lord, like, I'm just waiting for, you know, it to just blow up. Like, you know, and again, culturally, or if you understand, you know, that's what I meant. And so God, like, I literally heard God say, make it plain. And I'm like, what are you talking about here? Blow up. And I'm like, come on, Holy Spirit, you're picking up what I'm putting down. So then I had to think, okay, so if I had to say this, right, if you had to say what you wanted to a person that had the capacity to make it happen, blow up, like that's slang. Because in reality, blow up is not a good thing. And I understood exactly where God was bringing me to. And God was saying to me, right, in our prayers, in our petitions, sometimes it's just, and I, even as I was reading the comments about what can't go with you into 2022 or what you need God to do, sometimes, right, we're so broad and we're so big and it's just not even, it's like, and I feel like I've said this before, and it's almost like God is like, I can't compute. I can't, can you really make this thing plain? Can you really write the vision and make it plain so that somebody can, so that your angels can get it and run with it? And so if I had, and so I said, I want for my business to be successful. God said, okay, I understand success. And so then I was in my Bible app and I typed the word success. And I think I was in the NIV first. Or the King James. I think it was the King James. And this is what's so amazing. The word success is only in the Old Testament. It's not even in the New Testament unless you like go to maybe like, because I started looking up translations and I started looking up success and I started thinking about the ways the word success was used. The first time, and again, I think it was the King James, that the word success is used is when the servant is praying to God to be successful with getting a wife for Abraham. And then of course, for me, the most familiar passage of using the word success is when God is talking to Joshua and he promises Joshua good success if Joshua meditates and does what he says, all right? He says, if you meditate on the book of the law day and night. And so this is what God is saying. This is ultimately, right? This is ultimately where I'm trying to get you. I'm trying to get you to a posture where when we are petitioning God, when we are going to God, when we are praying, right, it is very plain to God the desires of our heart. It is plain to God the prayers and petitions that are coming out of our mouths. It is very plain to God when we are saying restoration. This is what I mean when I say restoration. I mean, I want for my spouse to be home permanently. I want for all of the arguing to be gone. I want for there to be give and take in our love between each other. When I am telling God, I don't want any more lack, right? For me, that may be, I don't want to live check to check. I don't want for it to be Christmas time and the bills are paid, but I don't know how to get, I want to give somebody a gift. Or maybe for somebody else, lack is way more extreme. And lack is, I need to get out of this place of homelessness. I need to get out of these living conditions. So this is all I'm saying, right? All I'm saying is, with God, make it plain. Make it plain. Make it plain. We have become so spiritual and so deep that literally God is saying to us, make it plain. Make it plain. Somebody, and listen, and I also, for me, and this is something that God literally checked me on. So let me just put this here, because one of the things I said I was going to leave in this year is not promoting my business, right? And I've been praying a lot about God in general, but I wrote that. Do you know that in looking up the word success, a scripture that I found that is in the New Testament, and again, it might be the Passion Translation, is John 7:4. And I've never read the scripture before. And basically it says, if you want to be publicly known, if you have a business that you want to blow up, why are you trying to build it in secret? And I literally was shook, because especially for kingdom people, we struggle. And I know we struggle, because I talk to other kingdom entrepreneurs. We're taking that marketplace business and introducing it to our ministry. We struggle with the right and wrongness of that. We struggle with, I don't know if I should be charging for this. I don't know if I should. And so here is the word of God. This is John 7:4 saying, how are you trying to be publicly known? How are you trying to be successful in something that you're keeping a secret? I had never read that before. It was, and I'm telling you, that's how me and God do. Like, God is like, listen, you don't have to give public opinion. Here is the word of God saying, right? You can't be successful with one or two people buying a book. You can't be successful that way. So why are you building it? Why, if how you've cultivated your, again, right? For me, I journal my time with the Lord. And so I made a journal called My God Time. Somebody emailed me. I had never promoted it here. Somebody emailed me because she was on Amazon and she typed my name in and she found the book and she got the book and she said, oh my gosh. And she knows who she is. She said, I ordered 7 more for people. Like, she literally said that to me, but I'm not telling you all. And that was tremendous in my own life. You got that thing inside of you that you know could bless somebody else, and you're not talking about it. Because I don't know how people are going to respond. I don't know how people are going to take this. This is what we struggle with, kingdom people. I don't know. I have that thing that I know I want God to. You know exactly where you want God to have you in 2022, and you are not making it plain. And if you're praying about it, you're using these deep terms, and God is like, what are you talking about? Or you're not even speaking it. So listen, as we prepare to exit out of the old, right? I encourage you that with your prayers, with your petition, with your posture, make it plain. You can't worry about who's going to feel some type of way, who's going to be in judgment, who's going to not support you, who's going to say you're still praying about that. You can't worry about, wow, Romania said I should be praying this way about my marriage, and I've been praying this way about, listen, go ahead, receive the correction. Okay, I'm not even going to worry about all the times I was praying this way. I'm praying this way, and I'm going to keep it moving. As of this day, right, Abraham couldn't say, okay, but I've been here for 75 years. Oh, you said go ahead and go? You're going to make my name great? Okay, I'm gone.